Welcome to part 2 of this video series, which is about recording electric guitar from the control room. Today I want to test a setup that may very well be the cheapest way to record your tube amp. And I'm saying this because for this setup you don't need microphones or anything like that. In fact, you don't even need a guitar cabinet. All you need is a way to capture your amp sound directly to your audio interface, and this may be done with a capture box or, in my case today, with a very cheap attenuator that has a line out and is safe to use without plugging in any speakers. Now, the whole concept is that you record your tube amp straight to the audio interface, and in the beginning it may sound something like this. Which is not a usable sound, but it's not meant to be one. The next step of this process is to use a plugin that will help you load a cabinet impulse response. An impulse response, or an IR, is in simple terms a profile of a real speaker recorded with a real microphone that you can use and manipulate and send your amp sound through. So today I won't test 4 different IR loaders, 2 paid ones and 2 that are free. The first one is the Torpedo Wall of Sound, which is one of the most known names in this field. The second one is the Nadir or Nad IR, I don't know. The third one is the Cabinet Section of Bias FX, and the fourth one is Ampire, which is free, with the Studio One, which is the DAW that I'm using. Also, before we get started, the amp that I'm using today is my favorite, kind of a twin reverb, which right now is cranked to about 7 or 8 out of 10. First thoughts, I really am not used to listening to my amp having this sound at this low of a volume, because right now in the room I can comfortably talk above the sound of my amp, and quite honestly it makes it more difficult to play. As far as sound quality goes, I will listen back to each plugin, but my first thought is that this may be something useful to have in my arsenal, but I don't think it will be one of my primary options here in the studio, because quite honestly I don't like the feel of it. Okay, so some quick thoughts. I know that I didn't match the sound of these plugins, and also I know that in order to achieve the best results with cabinet impulse responses, you need to search a lot and mix many of them together to achieve a more natural sound. Also, I think that this kind of workflow is excellent for someone that is recording in his home and can't really be obnoxious with his amp level, as long as he really tries and learns some of these programs. That's it. Of course, one of the major advantages of this setup is that you can literally have as many cabinets as you want without having to pay the same amount of money and without needing the space to store them. So, of course, I think that if the sound is good, it will be a nice option to have here. Anyway, let me know in the comments if you liked any of these 4 sounds, if you found them usable or not. Thank you very much for watching. My name is Talam, and I'll see you in the next one.